All right, so good morning, Vietnam.
Hey, hey, hey.
Hey, we got the swapping shop going strong in here. Got Milton in there. Hayden. So I'm sure everybody just heard me say good morning, Vietnam, live on the swapping shop. So we got Jason Winn with Winn Insurance here today.
Good morning.
Win the game. Don't lose everything. And if you've got long-term care insurance, I call that the unicorn right now because it's rare. But with new products, everybody can have it. I mean, everybody should have it because that keeps you from losing everything, okay? And, man, you don't talk about the dream team. You have that, and your insurance professional, and your elder law attorney and estate planning attorney working together. That's the dream team right there. And that can really protect you overall. So we're going to do a whole show based around that today. Aren't we, Hayden?
We absolutely are.
Okay. Tell everybody, hey, Hayden.
Good morning.
Do you have any wisdom? What's your happy place on today?
It is going to be on the largest, the biggest, the tallest.
I don't know. Okay.
The largest, the biggest, the tallest.
I'm not sure what. Okay. Buildings?
My son-in-law. Excuse me.
The Burj Khalifa?
Yes.
Okay.
I
know where she's going with that. I know where she's going.
My son-in-law proposed to his fiancée.
On the Burj Khalifa?
On the
top?
At the very top, yes.
Okay.
VIP
person. Dude, man, I'm telling you, Dubai was my second home when I was in the military. I love that place. People don't understand. They think the desert's camels and people riding around and wearing dresses, but it's not.
Yeah, I want to go there and I want to go down to Southeast Asia.
Kuala Lumpur?
Anywhere, Vietnam.
Singapore.
I've been to Thailand, but sure.
Busan, South Korea?
Exactly, anywhere.
Seoul, Busan.
My entire
talk
is just went back from a
former. Oh, I followed the whole thing on social media. She put everything on social media. Yeah, she was in Hong Kong. I was in Hong Kong before it went back to the Chinese and after it went back to what do you want to do? So the headphones, only thing it does is you can hear music with your brother or something like that. And sometimes when Phil will get really into it, and he will, she will work. Sometimes he'll play good music. Like, is he going to play happy place music? About his parents and stuff like that. Go ask. Oh, we're on. You got the whole, does this it? Good morning. It's Greg McIntyre, the elder law guy, here for the Elder Law Report. And I have a crowded studio here this morning in the Dan Patrick room, sitting around the octagon. And if you want to see what we're doing right now, go to our Facebook page, live on Facebook at McIntyre Elder Law, and you can watch the broadcast. So you can see what all our characters look like up here. I have a face that was made for radio. But everybody else looks good this morning.
I think it's eye candy myself.
There,
two good-looking guys here, and look at this pretty girl, and she's got a set of legs. She's so pretty.
I don't know what Hayden's talking about, but let me tell you what's going on this morning. Don't lose everything. Win the game with long-term care insurance, okay? We're going to talk about the new world of long-term care insurance, which has been totally revamped. I call long-term care insurance the unicorn because it's rare. When I find a client with long-term care insurance, you know, it makes my planning job a lot easier. You know, I can't provide as many legal services to them because I tell them they don't need as much as some of the others. Because you know what? They've got that base covered where if something happens to them, maybe their spouse, they've got it paid for. They've got everything paid for. They can stay at home. How many people want to go to a long-term care facility here? Please raise your hands. Me. You don't hear that very much. No. I mean, that's not my choice. I want to stay at home, you know? And hang out.
The majority.
Yeah, and have you know, kind of be taken care of in my own house if I need it, you know?
As
hopefully I won't need
possible.
It. Hopefully nobody else will need it. But you know, the reality is that 70% of seniors over 65 today will need some type of long-term care, be it in-home assisted living or nursing home care. That's just the facts, Jack. You know? So you know,
for
either
an average of 3 years.
And I say that is much. Those odds are much better or worse than Vegas odds. And Vegas what?
Vegas takes the money and leaves you with empty pockets.
Yeah. Vegas wasn't built on winners, right?
That's why I don't gamble in Vegas.
There you go. I mean, so don't get why, so
me.
Why would
going
you work your entire life to accumulate wealth, to accumulate something, to pay off a house and a mortgage for 30 years, only to lose it in the end, in the last few of the years of their life? And that's my mission behind why I do what I do, is I hate that. I mean, I can't stand it. People work their whole lives and lose it in the last few. But anyway, before I get into it too much, I'm going to get on my high horse, and we don't want to do that this morning yet. But I've got Jason Winn in here, who's a friend of mine. I've known Jason since I was a young kid. Can't remember not knowing Jason. And we'll have Jason as our featured guest and special guest today. He has Winn Insurance, and he does all kind of insurance planning for seniors and their families and beyond. Okay? And also, hey, Jason, thank you for being with us this morning.
Thank you, hey.
Thank you. Good morning. And are you affiliated with Nationwide?
We are a Nationwide. We have Nationwide as one of the companies that we represent. Mm-hmm. We do.
Okay. Awesome. Yeah. Nationwide, I mean, man, they're Nationwide. I want Milton to do all these sound effects. On my high horse, I want to hear a horse. Like, right? So, anyway, I'm sorry, guys. I had a cup. There is a coffee now that you can buy in your local store that's called Turbo. Okay.
And you had a double filter.
It's called Turbo.
We need a Keurig.
Oh, and I had a large carafe of that this morning and Waffle House. I went to the Waffle House this morning.
And then you doubled up.
Yes. I have a little thing called the Waffle House.
We made it here in 14 minutes and 10 seconds.
Go speed. So anyway, all right. Hayden, it's time for your happy place almost.
Yes,
but
almost.
First, let's introduce Taylor.
Yes.
We have Taylor here this morning. Taylor's been with us for a while now, and we were gonna let her get out of the office. Let her get in the sunlight. So I bring her up out of the basement, let her get out of the office and hang out with us, because she does a ton in our office, from really everything. She's done about everything, you know, and knows our departments well. And we want to introduce her to the audience as well as start having her maybe as a guest on the show.
Absolutely.
She's really your protege.
Well, yes, and sometimes Hayden might not be here.
She could be your daughter, her granddaughter. She could be your granddaughter.
She's young enough to be out there. That could be.
Yeah. So, anyway, thank you for being here, Taylor.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
Did you prepare anything special to say today?
I really just want to watch. I mean, I want to talk to you soon, too, but
this is her virgin broadcast.
Yay.
That we're going to...
So
yeah, you gotta ease me in, Greg.
I got you, but I mean, you gotta have something to throw out there.
I won my kickball game last night.
You won your kickball game.
I won my kickball game last night.
There you go.
It was a big game last night too.
When you're on the air with me, you gotta be able to improv.
I will.
You are on a kickball team.
I am on a kickball team.
There are things out there called kickball leagues.
There are for
Gaston County. Okay, gotcha.
And
Gaston
County. Yeah, and softball. Huge.
Well, you were a big softballer. Right?
I was. I played in college.
Played in college. Mm-hmm. That's right. Yeah. I like softball too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But
well,
you're a big winner this week too.
Why am I a big winner?
You
winner,
are
winner,
a big
chicken
board,
dinner?
Board member.
Oh, yeah,
of the
year.
I thought it was volunteers.
Volunteer year. At the senior center, the Leona Neal Senior Center in Cleveland County.
Yeah. We believe in that cause, and that's in the area of what we do. So. That's not mine, really. That's the whole office's, because we worked very hard to raise a lot of money for the senior center last year.
With a big contribution from you, raised $3,000 for their Meals on Wheels program.
Yeah.
And we do seminars there for their members.
Sure.
And, of course, you're sitting on the board, and I was privileged to sit there, last week.
Appreciate that.
Enjoyed that.
Thank you. So anyway, Hayden, what's your happy place today?
Well, I was looking at a picture of my grandson proposing to his fiance, and they did it at the top of the Burj Khalifa.
The Burj Khalifa.
In Dubai. And it just got me thinking, that's the tallest building in the world. So what are the other
tallest? Is it still called the Burj Khalifa?
It
used to be the Burj Dubai. They call it the Burj. Now it's the Burj Khalifa.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what it is. Yeah.
All right.
I mean, you want to talk about a huge building. Look online and see. I mean, I want to say it's like 2.5 Empire State Buildings. It's unreal how tall it is compared to.
All right. It's 2,723 feet. Its observatory is 1,800 feet in the air.
Isn't that like half a mile or something?
Well, that's why it's... You're ahead of me a little bit.
Yeah. So so I'm going to be quiet.
The future, the future tallest building is going to be the Kingdom Tower in Saudi Arabia. And keep in mind that the Burj is 2,723 feet. This one's going to be 3,281 feet. It'll be completed in 2019. And let's see. I'm trying to look. One of them is like a half a mile. I think maybe the Burj, half a mile.
I want to say that that's the Burj. Yeah. Hey, look, I was in the military. I was in the Navy. And I spent a good amount of time in Dubai. I had, coming from growing up between Shelby and Bowling Springs in Cleveland County, North Carolina, my grand view of the Middle East and my thoughts were that it was just a lot of dirt and camels. And no, there's like this future city in the middle of the desert. And golf courses, man, the greenest, nicest golf course. You know the Dubai Classic, right? You've seen the Dubai Classic.
That's right. Tiger Woods plays in that area.
That's right, that's right.
And my son-in-law works over there and has played those courses.
Impeccably groomed. And it's all, because it's all irrigation. So they're not waiting.
Much
for
like Scottsdale or something.
It's not gonna rain. Yeah. So anyway, a lot of oil money coming out of the ground over there.
Well, think about the tallest building in the United States. We did have the tallest until the Burj was built.
Yes.
And then the World Trade Center, is no longer.
Right.
But the Burj is 2,723, and the Kingdom Tower is 3,281. Our tallest is 1,792 feet.
Oh, we're going to step it up.
We're in third place now.
Well, I hear we're building, there's some proposals in New York City coming.
Probably a Trump Tower.
The big Trump, the presidential.
Yes. We'll call it the huge.
The huge Khalifa.
The biggest building in the world is the New Century Global Center. Now, we're talking about biggest in terms of volume, or it's 18,298,648 square feet, and that is in China. And the longest bridge in the world is the Danyang Kunshan Grand Bridge. With apologies to anyone who speaks
please send your complaints.
And the length of the length of this building is 102.4 miles. That's what it says.
That doesn't even make any sense.
Well, I'm telling you, that's what it says.
Like if you laid all the feet from the end to end?
If you figure it takes about an hour to drive 60 miles, if you're going 60 miles per hour, consider this. Driving at that same speed, it would take you more than an hour and a half to cross. Oh, this is the bridge. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Whatever. The biggest building in the world, the New Century Global Center in China. 18,298
feet. That reminds me of when I was in China, I caught a great white shark. We were fishing.
You did?
It was huge.
Did you let it go?
It was huge.
It was huge.
Yes.
Yeah. Did you let it go?
No. Actually,
did you eat it?
No, it was 45 feet long.
You could have sold the shark for
I did not catch a great white shark. This is not true.
Well, I play along and then let you have your joke.
So,
I never know when you're talking.
So anyway, there are a lot of big things in the world, right?
Yeah.
So thank you for what else?
Nothing else. I just want to clarify that. It was the longest bridge in the world in China that was 102.4.
You know what? There are a lot of big things, and there are a lot of big problems that seniors and their families face out there. And one of the biggest ones is losing everything you've worked for. Hey, you might not have built the Burj Khalifa, the world's tallest building, or the world's longest bridge, but I'm pretty proud of what I've got. I ain't got a lot. I don't have a lot yet.
It is growing.
My six kids want everything I have all day. I love them. But you know what I mean? They take it. They don't want everything. They're just happy. But you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I mean, and we got to pay for everything as we go along, which is, I know, the accumulation phase that we'll talk about. But, I don't want to lose it all one day just because I didn't plan.
Well, you're lucky that you're at a firm where we have a wonderful elder law attorney.
Yes. Yes, and wonderful staff. So anyway, hey, if you want to call in, ask any questions of us about the show today, or you want to just comment on the show, or you have any questions, we'll put out the information on how you can meet Mr. Winn or talk to Mr. Winn. But if you have any questions as far as elder law goes, or any estate planning questions, how to protect your hard-earned money and property, either planning ahead or an emergency, you can reach us if you're in the in the WCSL listening area, which is really from Charlotte to Tryon, based out of Cherryville here in close to Shelby, where I practice. I practice at 123 West Marion Street in Uptown Shelby. But we have meeting places by appointment only in Charlotte and in Asheville, and also in your home. We come into home all the time and be glad to do that. You can call us at 704-343-6933. Also, you can reach us at WTZQ. If you're listening in the WTZQ, if you're in the WTZQ listening area, which is really where we broadcast on Sundays at 1:30 p.m. from Asheville back to Tryon, you can reach us in your area code at 828-398-0181, and we'd be glad to talk to you. We'd be glad to schedule an appointment in home or at one of our meeting spaces in Asheville or Charlotte that we take by appointment only. Hey, I'd like to introduce our special guest today, which is Jason Winn.
Great.
And Jason, you're a great golfer, I know. I don't know, are you a golfer or insurance?
Anymore. Rarely.
Rare golfer?
Rare insurance and golf.
But you did play in a tournament. Boys and girls.
Most recently, boys and girls tournament. My father and I had a great time. Thank you for sponsoring the team. Shane Barger from high school played with us.
I wish I would have played.
Tom, it was great.
Anyway, I knew I've known Jason forever. Went to church together growing up at Bowling Springs Baptist.
We did. Your dad taught RAs. My dad.
Yes.
Yeah. It's wonderful. Yeah. Great place to grow up.
That's right. That's right. And now, you are a community member. You do a lot of community service. You're raising a family.
We do. We have two kids. I have a 14-year-old daughter, 10-year-old son. My wife homeschools those.
Right.
So, hey guys, hey Winn family. I think they're listening.
Hey Winn.
Maybe they're even, on Facebook Live. So
sure. And when you're in business,
great family.
You're not the only one in business. Right. Everybody in the family's in business.
Absolutely.
You know? I mean.
Yeah. Now I don't have all six working for me like you do yet.
Yeah,
we only have two.
So. Trying to get production. Yeah.
Yeah, but that's what it's all about. You know that. You know my story, why I got into insurance, the miracle of life insurance that happened with.
Why don't
my
you tell us about your story? Why did you get into life insurance?
Well, 20 years ago.
Or insurance? How about not just life insurance?
Yeah, insurance, but life insurance in particular is what we're one of the things we're most passionate about. My mother passed away at age 42. So the distribution and the preservation phase of life, she never got into, but she was in the middle of that accumulation phase as the primary breadwinner for our household. My dad was a banker, but my mom owned her own business.
I remember that.
We were
young kids when that happened.
She did. She did.
She cut hair.
With cancer.
She cut hair.
Stuff. So
yeah. She used to come over to the house.
Far now, yeah, it's wonderful. But
I remember the pool, the above ground pool in the back.
Wasn't that great?
The Bowflex.
Wood Hill Acres.
You had the Bowflex, and she had her hair salon in the house, like
later,
on the side of the house.
Later, as cancer, ravaged her body, she moved that into the house, and that was a blessing to have her there close by.
And we shot some basketball out there.
Lots of good times. Firecrackers and golfers over in your neighborhood.
That's a bunch.
It's been great.
Yeah. We expanded that.
Lots of great memories.
And playing with fire.
But listen, man, Fred Hamrick came through the line at the funeral, not with a bucket of chicken, but with an actual check. And I will never forget that. It was like, we didn't have to move, we didn't have to change a place to live. Most traumatic things that can happen to folks beyond losing a parent or losing a child, a loved one, is to have to move schools, have to move their home. I imagine that compounding effect that happens all the time when people pass away. So we didn't have to move. We had a little starter fund, my sister and I. My dad was able to pay the house.
So he was your insurance agent.
Fred Hamrick Insurance, Maxby Hamrick Insurance in Wall Street, give them a plug. It's a great organization. They're competitors of ours, but we do different things from time to time. But that small little term policy that Mom had the foresight to purchase at age 38, was just a miracle. And so I am a proponent of that. I go out and preach that. Everyone can afford life insurance. Get it young, get it early. And then now it's moved so far, it hits all three phases of life. And as you do elder law planning with seniors, if they have the proper insurances in place, then they don't have to worry about some of these crisis planning things that we send so many people out of your office for.
Yeah. They don't have to worry about, hey, oh my gosh, I'm spending hundreds of thousands out on a spouse, and all our life savings are going to be gone.
That's right.
And we're going to maybe lose the house in the end if we pass.
Yeah, they can put that worry. And in the rearview window and move on
because they've got a long-term care policy that's kicking in and paying
If they have that, that's what I call winning the game. Right. To me, at the end of life, in the preservation phase of life, to leave a legacy, as you like to say, you know, assets
preserve
and legacy.
Your assets and legacy.
If you're going to preserve that, if you're going to have a legacy, you got to leave something besides just memories. Mm-hmm. And that's so important. They can do that, and then they win. You know, they can win all three phases of life, so it's great. Yeah.
I agree. So, Hayden, do you have any questions about long-term care insurance?
Well, I have two term policies, and they're for $100,000 each. When I got them, I think they were like $26 a month or something. And now, of course, they've gone up a couple of times since right. then, as you get older. But they're meant for young families to cover emergencies and things like that. But
you're
the long-term
exactly right.
care, since I have aged to the age I am, would have probably not the long-term care, yes, but a whole life policy would have continued on at the same early rate and given me the assurance that even after, there will be money for my kids and
well,
my
know,
grandkids.
Hayden, life insurance, just like an automobile, has gone through many changes. When our grandfather, Papa Mac, and Papa Joe were living and buying their first automobile, there was no power steering, there was no door locks, there were no automatic windows, defrosters, and all the stuff that we did. Heated seats, cooled seats. Your car probably has cooled seats and stuff.
It has heated seats.
Yeah, cruise control. He never uses it because it does 90 miles an hour. It is new. But my point is, life insurance used to only be whole life insurance, and then in the 70s we had term insurance. Then we had something called universal life. But as time moves forward, they advance it. So if you have term insurance like you do, then the first step would be to contact the company and see if it's convertible to a permanent policy. Mm-hmm. You mentioned whole life. It's an older product. It's been around for 150 plus years. But there are newer products on the market. If they will convert that, then you may not have to go through underwriting. And they might even include a long-term care rider with just minimal underwriting. Mm-hmm. But no need to get in the weeds for that. Just to say that life insurance has radically changed. So if you have a belief system that says life insurance is bad because there were bad products, just like bad used car salesmen.
Long-term care insurance.
Bad attorneys, not here, but yeah, absolutely. And long-term care has radically changed.
Yeah.
Standalone long-term care is moving by the wayside. There's few companies that offer it. People still think of that, just like
right.
they think about long-term care as a nursing home that smells like urine. No, not anymore. It's actually stay at home, have your family take care of you, have a bucket of money to pull out of, to refurbish the bathroom, to put down hardwood floors instead of carpet. All those things that you want to do for a senior, for a loved one, that you can do now. And
put a roll-in shower in. Or
oh, absolutely.
Yeah. Whatever needs to be done.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Who wants to lift their 150-pound husband into the tub?
Yeah.
You're not going to do that. You're going to need long-term care.
It's something
to do
we
that.
Don't think about,
right.
and we don't associate that with insurance. And
oh,
the products are different, I think. When you look at someone like Taylor, who's a young mother, and then me, you have grandchildren, and then you've got people who, some even my age, who now need what they should have bought years earlier that their children can buy now.
Great example here. Taylor should buy term insurance that's convertible to permanent. When she hits Greg and our age, because we're getting old, she should be looking to convert that because we have more disposable income, unless you have 19 children like Greg. But you should be able to afford the conversion.
I only have
so
six
that
my
when
wife.
You hit Hayden,
she won't take him.
Well, hey, when you hit your point in life, you're thinking about it because you've had parents who need long-term care. My grandparents recently passed in 2015, both had Alzheimer's. Well, all three, two grandmothers and grandfather, both had Alzheimer's, stayed at hospice or stayed in a care facility like Carillon for the long-term, for the Alzheimer's unit.
Yeah.
It was a wonderful experience, but it was $7,000 a month out of Papa Mac's pocketbook,
sure.
just like your book talks about. And we just don't have to do that anymore. And Carillon and Peak and those places love the
They love when
that's
in place because they know that, man, we don't have to scramble to figure out how you can pay for our services. And if this is going to be a short-term and long-term thing, you're in here, and we can take care for you, and you don't have to worry about it. Your family doesn't have to worry about it. It really is an unselfish thing to do as well because it takes the burden off the kids. It takes the burden off your spouse. It really does. So,
you're exactly right.
And I know, just speaking of grandparents, you have an office in Bowling Springs that is a, an old home place.
Great grandmother, grandfather, Sonny C. and Ethel Winn.
Right on Main Street there.
We're there. We're there, conveniently located in the booming metropolis of Boiling Springs, home of Tabernacle Tech, Beverly Hills.
But hey, it's a good.
That's what we used to call
it. It's a good. It's a good place for you. I know you do a lot of business this way in Cleveland County and also in Rutherford County.
We have
it's a good place for you to jump back and forth to.
We do. Yeah. And we live in Boiling Springs, so we love it there.
Yeah.
It's home.
Good place to raise a family.
It is.
No doubt.
Yep. And leave a legacy.
And leave a legacy.
That's right.
Sure. Sure.
Do you ever think about things like that? About getting insurance?
Yeah, I actually have insurance already.
Good for you.
Good for Olivia.
That's commendable.
And she's very smart.
I do.
I assume that would be
she
the
has insurance because she's smart. That's right.
And you want to be able to think. How, you know, how am I going to replace my income? Mm-hmm. How am I going to send my child to college, my children to college? How am I going to, you know, for me, you know, how would my wife, if I left, right, if I wasn't mm-hmm. here, if I left this earth, you know, if I passed away, how would she afford to send all the kids to school?
You actually don't think about that until you actually leave my kids. Well, that never crossed my mind.
The other goal, too, what if your wife were to pass? What is her human life value? Mm-hmm. Taking care of the children, running your household.
I think I have a rider on my policies that would.
Yeah. Oh my goodness, you need like $5 million.
Yes, daycare for six, that's about right.
Absolutely. Can you imagine the on-pair, the nanny, all the things you would need at your house? You'd have to build another house to move those folks in to run the household. Greg, Stephanie is that bad.
Okay, she is. Yes, she is. Yes, she is. Yes, sweetheart, I'm going to talk to Jason about
absolutely. I know she's listening. Julie's listening, so.
And,
well, and we all know that people who have had accidents early in life and, you know, passed away or became disabled, you can't assume. I had six wrecks in 2 years. Any of them could have been really, really bad. So mm-hmm. it can happen to anybody at any time. So everybody.
We can't say that.
Six wrecks in 2 years.
We can't say that. He's going to come back and look up your record.
Six wrecks in 2 years are great.
But they're not.
We recommend that to everyone.
It's not fun.
That's like the first recommendation we make is, have you had a wreck recently? Okay, great.
Yeah. I'm driving home, Hayden.
Yeah.
Okay, so the whole point for me is, I see people who are in danger all the time of losing assets because of a tragic healthcare situation in the family. And if you have, and with the revolutionary changes in life insurance and riders for long-term care, you can have those things in place and they'll pay off a ton more than you invest in them. And they are also beneficiary assets, which allows you to pass them to the kids, grandkids, if you don't use them.
Tax-free.
So there's multiple benefits, and a lot of people I meet with do have money in insurance that they've, you know, whole life policies, or 401ks, IRAs, or
a checking account.
Yes, but they're not touching it. And I say, you know,
sleeping asset.
I look at it as like these soldiers in a fort. Send a few out, man, to fend off the attacking horde, and then with that, with products like that, you can call them back in if you want.
Exactly.
You can cancel it either without
it's not a use it or
burden
lose it.
A lot of time.
Yeah. I'm not talking about use it or lose it things.
It used to be that way.
That's exactly right.
Had a bad rep.
You use it and keep it.
Yeah. So, thank you so much for being on the show today.
I appreciate it.
We've got about 5 minutes left, so we're going to work to wrap up the show, okay? And I wanted to say thank you for being on the show today.
Taylor,
last week we talked about Hayden just being so outgoing and how she does this with ease. And she said, I don't think I could have done this when I was younger.
Right.
With maturity. I just
hold on.
With seniority.
Am I going to be, is it okay?
No,
to turn around?
I tell everybody, okay? I'm proud to still be alive this day.
As she lived life and learned lessons, she learned just really not to care at all about what other people thought, and she expresses herself freely, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm glad you came on today, right? And through that, you know, confidence and things like that are just like a muscle that I think you can build, you know?
Absolutely. I said, I'm excited to get the training wing. I'm going to learn a lot. I already know I am.
I know.
Well, you can kick me in gear and get me going a little faster.
So, Jason, thank you for being on the show. And, Jason, if people want to contact you and they want to ask, hey, can you meet with me? What is that going to be like? Do they have to wait a long time? Do they have to come to your office? Will you go to them?
One thing I recommend is they call McIntyre Elder Law.
Okay.
You all have a wonderful process where you evaluate all the things in their life, all the needs they have, and package that up. Then that document, with their permission, can be sent to me. We'll set an appointment. Our office will call and schedule the appointment. And then we'll meet. If they want to find more information about me, Facebook is the best way. So Facebook, Winn Insurance, WINN, my last name, Insurance, all one word. Facebook, that's the best way to get a hold of us.
Winn with two N's.
We have some areas that don't have Facebook because they don't have good coverage, Wi-Fi.
704-482-7746.
Again, Winn Insurance,
704-482-7746.
7746. To win the game, there's so much winning going on, it's too much for one end. So it's Winn with two ends.
That's right.
Right? Game with Winn Insurance with Jason Winn. And he'll help support your family. He's got his own support too.
Absolutely.
I appreciate that. I really enjoy working with men and women who are hardworking business people.
I want to say, when they call that number, they're going to talk to my fantastic staff.
Yeah.
Alicia, Lisa, and Jody.
Sure.
They're listening.
Okay,
yeah,
great.
They're great.
Every program, they never miss a program. That's right.
So what else do we have going on, Nate?
I'll tell you. On May 31st, we'll be at the Gaston County Senior Health Fair in Dallas. On June the 6th, Greg's been asked to be a keynote speaker, and we'll have a booth at the Care for Caregivers Conference. And this is the Foothills Higher Education Building on Sterling Street in Morganton. And it's sponsored by the CARE Foundation. So if you are interested in this, if you want to find out if you qualify to go, if you're a caregiver or want to exhibit, the number is 828-201-5728.
Fine, I'll be there. I can't wait. I'm excited.
Oh, you love
it. And tune in next week where you'll hear about what?
Next week we have Lighthouse. Billy Peeler of Lighthouse Senior Consulting Services, and he helps families through the home health care assistance.
Can't wait to have Billy.
If you don't know where to start, you've all of a sudden been told by the discharge planners, he'll help.
Thank you very much, Milton. And if you'll play us out, thanks everybody for being here. Thanks everybody for hanging with us today. And I love radio, iHeartRadio, and WCSL and WTZQ. Peace. Hey, good job, man.
Good job.
So we're going to leave the live video on his Facebook, and that's just like the after party, you know what I'm saying? Like Bill Maher, after we go.
Bring in the chicken wings. You know, all those AM radio stations, they have a restaurant that sponsors all the shows and bring in all the food. You guys don't do that?
We need a sponsor. That's an idea.
I thought about doing that. We should bring in food.
Do you want to start... We should start sponsoring the shows. Really, we should pay nothing.
Michael over at Chan.
We should start sponsoring the show.
That's exactly.
Shout out there. Who wants to be our sponsors?
Who sponsors the show? Mitchum's Kitchen needs to be a sponsor.
Oh, I love Mitchum's Kitchen.
Look at that.
Mitchum's Kitchen. And West Lincoln is so good.
There's the takeout.
We can't get here about how much, though, can we? No.
So call Mitchum's Kitchen. See if they want to sponsor.
I know the owner.
Why wouldn't they do it?
Sell some sponsorships for the show.
I can.
And we won't be paying for WTZQ or WCSL.
Have you ever been to City Lunch in Lincolnton?
No. That sounds good, though.
Oh, my God.
Should we move into Lincolnton?
I'm serious.
No, I'm serious. Because we've been trying to figure out where besides just Cleveland County. We love Cleveland County. But where besides, you know, we're broadcasting in Hendersonville, so that makes sense. Let's get stuff on in Hendersonville. I like Lincoln County, too. What do you
think? I'm telling you. They have a lot of
Why don't you
They have like a shag every Thursday for a live at 5. You can set up a booth and get so many clients that way.
Okay.
I'm telling you.
The shaggers, we're talking about my generation.
Oh man, the shaggers.
Yeah.
The shaggers.
That's like 91
hours. We have to go on Thursday. We're going to go on Thursday.
I think that's a great idea. Let's stop, you know, paying for the radio show. Let's actually give the station. We can do things for the station. I mean, we'll figure it. Calvin and I'll figure that out. The owner, and
And we can do WCSL that way too. We'll figure that out. I think that's a great, I thought about that before. We just did not have the resources to capitalize on
that. Did I give you that
idea?
Do I get credit for that?
Yes. Sure, you should be on more. You should be on more.
It's another free consultation.
Like so Jamie Richard and I did one called the Dream Team. Your attorney and financial planner working together.
How about that?
I mean the insurance.
Jamie's a good guy.
The other dream team is
Recommend
really
Scott Sharp.
Insurance.
Yeah.
Scott Sharp. Yeah, Scott,
Scott is there, you talking about three people there?
No, I was talking about, you know, we should have Jason on again. These days
maybe with Scott. Maybe we'll look Scott in.
You know, Scott should come in. I haven't talked to Scott about coming in and doing that. But Scott should
come
in. That
would be a great one. You'd just be the guys. And
Jason's our being our
Stephen president. Price. You know, Stephen Price is a hoot.
Yeah, oh, he is.
Good guy to have on.
He is. He's got a good story, too.
Yeah.
Yeah. But thanks for being on. I mean, I talk about the hybrid products all the time. I mean, it doesn't make sense to me why more people don't do it.
They're scared it's going to cost too much money.
Yeah.
That's the number one fear.
Well, I mean,
it's too expensive.
But it doesn't cost to ask you.
Oh, no, it's free.
And that's right. And you're not going to give them grief if they can't afford it. 99%
of the time, we find the money for them.
Uh-huh.
It's there.
How
we
is
find
that?
It for them. Well, okay.
I want to find mine.
So Taylor has a term policy.
Yep.
And she may not realize that it converts to something permanent. And if not, maybe we ought to have the conversation of aligning her with a company, and maybe we save her money on her term insurance so that later on in life she can save that money and then convert and pay for it. No money out of pocket. You know, so.
That's what I tell people.
Didn't cost her anything.
Yeah.
Well, I appreciate being on show, man.
Oh, and if that doesn't work, I'll get you a raise.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's even better. that's your next bet on the golf course.
So we need to go out and play some golf. I need to get Shane, and Shane to play one of
these. In your spare time.
I would say Sunday, but I think it's going to rain in the show this weekend.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Well, this has been good.
Yeah.
Good
if you want to go
Thank
to Whitewater Center, I know my wife told me Saturday morning we're going to head down there.
You're taking the whole family?
Yeah.
To the Whitewater Center?
Mm-hmm. And we can do, I mean, Jordan and I can go mountain biking, Tucker, and then we can, Steph loves to do the climbing walls.
That sounds great.
Feel free to go.
Okay. Just run around and buy ice cream.
Of stuff, yeah. We should do a seminar at the Whitewater Center. They have a great meeting.
Really?
I did not know that.
We could take our staffs and
we should do a seminar with Jason.
Men insurance against.
See, Jason will do a seminar. The partnering doing seminars is great because you can offer more value to the customer. You share costs, right?
Mm-hmm.
I want to do one at BB&T Ballpark.
That'd be fun.
Ballpark.
That'd be fun. Okay. I think they have a room that overlooks the
I've got season tickets down there if you ever want to go.
Wow.
Two tickets there we get. Yeah. Right behind.
Is that the Knights?
Yeah, the Charlotte Knights. Right downtown if you
want to do that.
Come with me.
Hey,
we need to go.
Sorry, you don't get music tickets anymore.
We need to go. I haven't gone yet. And the season's been started.
I'm going to say it's already started.
Hey, I want to give you guys this. I don't know if you've ever seen it or not, but the insurance commissioners, the United States insurance commissioners from all over the different states, put that together. It's a free resource. You should give it to everyone when you mention long-term care. It's
okay.
Free. Just give it out. And they'll send you free into your office. They'll send it to you.
Do you have a sticker on your insurance?
I do not, but I should do that. I can get you as many as you want. I've got some information about one of Nationwide's problems for you guys.
If you got stickers or something like that, or maybe we can share something with them.
Yeah.
Hey, Milt, thank you very much.
All right. You're welcome.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
I saw a couple of our pieces of material that
we
need to get our name on too.
We have a stapler.
Yeah, why don't we just staple Winn's card to it. That's a great idea in my office to set it on the conference table and get people to ask me about it.
It's, you know, it's not put out by an insurance company. It's put out by insurance commissioners. Yeah.
And then I, you know, I'm just saying it'd be a great segue to that conversation.
Absolutely.
Anyway, thank you everyone for watching and listening. And if you have any questions, call Jason Winn. He's the man about insurance.
We'll help you win the game.
Taylor, when we get back,
mm-hmm.
Do you have more than one card?
Oh, gosh, yes.
You need a few cards.
We don't
have one
card. I think they're free. You know, just tell me, I'll get you some.
That's smart. Do me a favor.
Okay.
Staple those
50.
To the front of these things,
okay.
And put them up front on our conference. Okay. And Mitchum's Kitchen. Let's call Mitchum's Kitchen. And whoever else we think might be, make a short list of.
You guys just check that out.
How about make a list of 10 potential sponsors for our show? And hey, if you want to go, if you went through all those CDs that we had, those two stacks on of shows, we've had a ton of businesses on the show. I mean, there's a lot of people that might want to get shout
outs. That's right. Why not?
You
know
what I'm saying?
Why not? This was fun. Thank you, Greg.
Yeah, man. Absolutely.
It's a good way to break up a Friday, man. That's awesome.
See you guys. See you next week.
Thanks.